It's AumSum time!
What if wheels were never invented?
No problemo. I'll just use my private rocket.
Oh, AumSum. Wheels are believed to have been invented almost 5,500 years ago. Ever imagined what the world would be like without wheels? Huh? How would you go to school, work, or even on a holiday? Bicycles, cars, steam engines, and even planes, nothing would be possible without the wheels. Yes, horses and sledges would be there, but it would be a super slow and super rough ride. Not only in transportation, but wheels are also a major component of the Industrial Revolution. Elevators, blinds, cranes, etc. all have some form of wheel hidden in them. Now, on adding teeth to wheels, gears were invented. Clocks, grinders, car engines, bicycles, and other complex machines work with the help of gears. So, basically, if wheels were never invented, we might still be living the prehistoric way.
What if we stop drinking water?
We will have to sell our water purifiers to scrap dealers.
Ah, you are unbelievable. About 60% to 80% human body is water. We need water for various purposes like digestion and excretion. Water is also a major component of blood. However, every day we lose about 2 to 3 liters of water through sweat, urine, breathing, etc. Hence, to compensate the water loss, if we don't drink enough water, then we will get dehydrated. During dehydration, our brain works harder than normal. It informs kidneys to retain moisture, thus producing darker, concentrated urine. It reduces the production of saliva, causing dry mouth. Lack of water also causes our brain tissues to shrink. We get headaches and feel nauseous. Our energy levels drop and our skin becomes dry. Besides this, chronic dehydration can lead to severe health problems and even death.
What happens if a plane is struck by lightning?
It will start glowing like a disco ball.
No! Lightning is a massive flow of charge which carries thousands of volts of electric current. Thus, it is extremely fatal for living beings and can damage anything that comes in its way.
Yeah, dude. It is really terrifying.
Now, many times, airplanes get caught in a heavy lightning storm. However, airplanes are designed to handle the lightning strikes. The outer skin of most planes is primarily made of aluminum. Aluminum is a good conductor of electricity. When lightning hits the airplane, the electric current travels through the outer skin of the plane. It does not pass into the plane. Eventually, it exits off through another extremity, such as tail. Thus, the airplane and the passengers within remain protected.
What if you fell into a black hole?
I'll color it with my color pencils.
No. Boundary of the black hole is called event horizon. Small black holes have stronger gravitational forces than large ones. If you fell towards a small black hole, strong gravitational forces would stretch you until you are torn apart, even before you cross the event horizon. In case of a large black hole, you'd be able to enter it unharmed, falling freely until you reach its center or point of singularity. Here, you'd get squashed and merge into it. But your friend observing this from outside never actually sees you enter the black hole. He just sees you fall in slow motion, freeze, and then go dimmer. Why? Because our current laws of physics don't apply beyond the event horizon, making it impossible for us to see beyond.